Valsakumar P Menon, or VP as he is popularly known as, is a motivational speaker, a trainer, and a coach. He comes with over 2 decades of corporate experience, having worked with multinational organizations in India and the Middle East in the fields of training, supply chain management, international trade and business development, operations management, and quality management. His career with the multinationals has given exposure to markets spanning India, Far East, Middle East, Africa, Europe, and America. As managing partner of UV Consultants, VP today uses all his experience and knowledge to do what he does best and what he is most passionate about, which is training, coaching, and consulting. VP is passionate about bringing out the best in people and helping organizations and individuals add value to whatever they do. He believes in an engaging, lively, and practical approach to training and has a proven track record as an effective leader and communicator. VP firmly believes that it's never too late to start improving and adding value to your life, and hence loves the quote from Karl Barth, which says, "Though no one can go back and make a brand new start, anyone can start from now and make a brand new ending." VP has a master's in business administration and he is a certified international professional training consultant. He is a distinguished Toastmaster from Toastmasters International. He is also a certified NLP master practitioner and coach, certified NLP trainer, certified group coach, and certified accelerated learning coach.
There is a say, if you carry your childhood with you, you will never get old. Our guest today is a person who has literally implemented this say in his life. The first letter of his name is V for versatility. He is a great orator, motivation speaker, trainer, and a born leader. The next letter of his name is P for performance. He is a great performer. In short, he is a versatile performer. Many people look for beautiful places, but some people make the place itself beautiful with their presence. I'm extremely happy to introduce such a person who makes the place beautiful itself with his magical presence. A person who is very funny, as enthusiastic as a child, so much versatile and flexible, and overall a great human being. Welcome to the 8th episode of Positive Media. I am privileged to be with a distinguished Toastmaster, an established trainer, and an entrepreneur. Our versatile performer, DTM VP Menon.
Thank you very much.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
So, which place are you originally from, and how many years have you been staying here in UAE?
I came to UAE in 1999, so it's been exactly 20 years now. I grew up in Bombay, Mumbai.
Yes.
Yeah, but my parents are from Kerala. So they're from Thrissur, a place called Guruvayur. But I grew up in Bombay. So yeah. So Bombay is my base basically.
You are a seasoned Toastmaster, being with the fraternity for more than 15 years, I must say.
17 years.
17 years then. So can you please narrate the history of Toastmasters in UAE?
See, they say seasoned only because of this. Yeah, nothing else. So when I came into Toastmasters in 2002, 17 years ago, we had around 30 odd clubs in the UAE. The first club was Abu Dhabi Toastmasters Club, and the second club was Dubai Toastmasters Club. And I joined Dubai Toastmasters Club. But today we are more than 130 clubs in the UAE. So the growth has been tremendous, you know.
Yes.
It spiked up, you know, after 2002 and all, when we joined,
yes,
it spiked
all
up. Development. Yeah, it picked up drastically. And even today, the speed continues. I mean, there are so many communities, there are so many universities,
yeah,
there are so many companies where Toastmasters Club,
of
because
course,
they all understand the value of the program and they keep opening new clubs.
You are known as a humorous speaker among Toastmasters. What is your formula in becoming one of the best humorous speakers?
Well, I would not say that I'm one of the best humorous speakers. By chance, I found out that I could be humorous. Now, there were certain humorous genes in me which I didn't know existed. Yeah, because my mom, she used to be very humorous. And I had that quality in me, but I was not using it, you know. But when I joined Toastmasters is when I started realizing that, hey, I have that knack of being humorous.
Yes.
So, and I mostly believe in, I don't believe in, you know, humor which is practiced too much. So
yes,
I'm more into, I love situational humor, impromptu humor. Yeah. So I'm humorous when I feel that there is something humorous. I don't come prepared that, oh, you know, I need to be humorous.
Oh,
so
yes. Of
that's
course.
How it works.
Yes, of course.
For me.
We always see you laughing, smiling, and spreading happiness. How do you manage such a funny life when you're busy with business, profession, and public speaking programs?
My life is not at all funny. Yeah, I may be funny, but my life is definitely not. See, all of us have our good side of life, our challenging side of life. We
yes,
all go through it.
Yes.
So I also go through it, but what helps me is I try looking, you know, focusing on the funny side of everything, the humorous part of everything. So even if it is something that goes wrong, that is not very comfortable, I still look at the funny side and laugh it off.
Yeah,
and then do whatever best I can to rectify the situation. And believe me, it really works. It works for me. It works for millions of people in this world. So people who look at the funny side of life always find better ways to sort out issues, challenges that crop up in their life.
Yes, no serious business.
No, humor is serious business. You have to take it seriously. Yeah, but
okay,
because there is some very serious benefit which you get out of humor.
Okay. Now, you are known as a trainer in the table topic segment. So how does table topic segment help someone in their day-to-day life?
See, table topics is something, as you all know, very, very crucial, right? In the entire Toastmasters program, that is one segment which becomes very, very crucial.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because in our day-to-day life or real life out there, we don't always get the opportunity or the time to prepare in advance. Yeah, many times life just throws certain things at us and we need to respond effectively, yeah, appropriately.
Yes.
So table topics is where that thinking on your feet, quick action, quick reaction, yeah?
Yes.
That comes in.
Yeah.
And that really helps you, whether you go for an interview, whether in schools, whether anything, anywhere, you know, whether you're a student, a professional, doesn't matter, a husband. I've been married for 25 years and believe me, table topics really comes in handy to handle your wife or your spouse, whoever, yeah, wife or husband.
You are known as an NLP certified trainer and a master practitioner. How does the NLP help students in facing their examinations effectively?
See, basically, I came across NLP around 4 years back and believe me, it's been an amazing program which is brought in a lot of changes in my life. NLP is a very simple thing. It's all about our mind. And most of the things in our life starts from here. The way we think, the way we perceive things. Yeah. So when you are able to manage your state, you will be in a better position to manage everything externally.
Yeah.
Many times people face challenges only because they are not able to manage things externally. The reason being, they're not able to manage things internally. As a student, you know, there are times, and I've gone through that too. You prepare very well, But when you go into the examination hall, you end up forgetting everything. Happens?
Yes.
That's because you've not been able to manage your states effectively. Now, NLP helps us to manage our states. Yeah, it's all about managing our states. And if we can manage our states, if we can have control over our states all the time and be resourceful all the time, believe me, a lot of issues that crop up in our life can be eliminated very easily. So it's all about managing our states. That's all.
I think I'll have to use this NLP before my math exam.
Yes, it is very, very effective. In fact, we in UE Consultants, our company, me and Uma, we run a program called Y2IM, Yes to Inspired Minds. And that's for children. Yeah, it's every Saturday for 2 hours. We had the session today morning also, where we use a lot of NLP. We teach children, you know, how to get out of such challenges that they face.
Okay. If you would like to see one change in our children's community, what would it be?
See, I am actually nobody to comment on what change the new generation should have. You know why? Because my generation is different from your generation. I have two teenage kids at home. Who am I to say what they are doing is not right? Yes, unless I know very well that whatever they are doing can get them into serious trouble, I need to tell them. But otherwise, the new generation does things very differently from what we used to do. So I always think that what I think is right is just my perception. But my perception was right in those days. But is my perception right today in the completely changed scenario with so many developments happening, technology changing, everything changing, you know? So I am nobody to comment on what changes they should make. They are doing what they feel is the right thing for them.
Yeah.
And as parents, your parents also would gently guide you when they feel that, you know, something is not really right. It can probably hurt you or may not be they will guide you definitely.
Yes, of course.
But believe me, I have full faith in today's generation and even my own children. I don't really tell them, you know, what to do step by step. No, I leave it to them. Yeah, I leave it to them to decide how they wish to travel their life's journey.
It's our decision. Right. As a coach, how do you help people to solve the situations that they are facing?
So what happens is I've been in this world for a few decades. Yeah.
Yeah. Of course.
As you can see. So there's a lot of experiences I've gone through. Good, bad, ugly. There's been a lot of people who have helped me in the process. There's a lot of things I have learned from people, from situations, from programs like Toastmasters and various other organizations, from NLP, from you know, other organizations I've been involved with. Now, as a coach, as a certified coach, when people come to me, I'm able to help them by guiding them in the right way. As a coach, I never tell them what to do. When they come to me with some challenges or some goal that they have where they need my help, I just facilitate the process of them finding solutions for their own problems or goals or challenges. Yeah. So as a coach, I don't give them the answers. I just facilitate because we all have the resources within us.
To.
Yeah. It's just that as a coach, I guide them in finding out those, tapping into those resources and bringing out their talents.
Yes.
So every individual human being here is well equipped and they have enough resources within them. Sometimes we are not able to understand those. Sometimes we are not able to tap into those. So as a coach, I guide them in the process. That's all.
Now, can you give us some tips to the Tejas Gavaliers to be a bit more humorous?
Well, see, I already see a lot of humorous people around here. Yeah, I mean, her speech today was very, very humorous. You have Vinod Metamal as one of the chief coordinators, right?
Yes.
He's a very, very humorous person.
Yes, he's really great.
So, to develop your humor skill, first and foremost, you need to decide that, hey, I want to improve my humor skills. The moment you make that decision, you will find a lot of ways to improve it. Now, there are various types of humor. Some of the humor that works best is, which I use for myself is, I make fun of myself. Now, people love it. See, even now they are laughing. People love it when we make fun of ourselves. Yeah?
Yes.
When we make fun of others or somebody else's situations, people may laugh, but they don't really like you as a person. Because making fun of others is not a good habit. Yeah. If you are a good person, you will never make fun of others.
Yeah.
You will. But making fun of yourself or self-deprecating humor, as we call it, is one of the most powerful humor. And the other kind of humor which I like is situational humor, where you pick up things from what's happening around you and use that as a humor, you know. This bookish humor where you read some jokes, you by heart some jokes and come and tell those. I mean, those, I don't find it very interesting. Yeah. So, but believe me, self-deprecating humor and situational humor are two types of humor which really works well. And people love them.
What is that wow moment you always remember in your professional life?
Well, that wow moment came, and then the third moment also came immediately after that. So the wow moment was when I started my first business, when I quit the corporate world and I'm starting that. It was wow. But then after about a year and a half, it was a big thud also. But then I started again and it was another wow, but it was not as wow as the first one, because you know how it is the first time. But then what helps me is, you know, today, when I'm successful in my current businesses, people ask me, you know, what do you attribute this success to? I attribute 90% of the success to that 1.5 years of failure that I had, because there was so much I learned from that, you know, and that is what really helps me.
Stepping stone to success.
Yes. So 24 years I spent in the corporate world, I attribute only 10% of my entrepreneur success to that, 90% to this failure. So believe me when I say this, that, you know, I don't mind saying that, stating that that failure was the wow moment for me.
Yes. Now my final question, what is the message you would like to give us, the Tejas Cavaliers, to improve better communication and leadership skills?
See, first of all, I would like to appreciate the fact that, you know, this club was started by Vinod Matamal and VG and so many other people who have been involved, the Toastmasters. And what I really like about this club is that extra effort that is being put in. Now, every gavel club has its meeting, you know, twice in a month. They come, they do all those segments and then finish it off. But what I see in gavel is, in this Tejas Gavel Club, is you do more than that. It's not just the meetings alone. It's just not just the speaking or the evaluations or the table topics. You do things like this, you know. So you go, you kind of get out of your comfort zone. You go and do a little bit more extra. And, you know, kudos to all of you and the counselors and the coordinators in making this happen. Now, so that itself is one step, you know. The other simple advice I would give you is attend all the meetings and try to grab roles here. Be greedy for roles. That's what I would say. Yeah, I use the word greedy. Be greedy to come here and do roles. Because at the end of the day, sitting in that seat is not going to help you much. What helps you is coming here and speaking.
Grabbing an opportunity.
Yeah. So attend all meetings and try to get maximum stage space, you know. That's what I would say.
Well, that was the end of my questions. So now the Tejas Cavaliers, who are free to ask questions.
Yeah, it's free. We don't charge you for asking questions.
Hi, sir. I'm Malvika. So I have this question for you. You have a lot of roles, like you are a human speaker, you have your profession on the other side, you are a coach, everything. So which is this one profession or like one job that is most closest to you in your heart?
So as you mentioned, I do have a lot of roles that I play in my life, but the most beautiful role that I'm playing right now is not my profession, not my career as a trainer or a coach or a speaker. It's my role as a father, as a husband, as a brother. Yeah. So that is one of the best roles. So for me, family comes first, everything else is secondary.
My name is Abhijit Babu, and my question is, where exactly do you practice getting better when it comes to situational humor? I know it all depends on what kind of situation it is. So how do you turn that into a comedy?
Very good. That's a very nice question. So when we talk about situational humor, how many of you watch stand-up comedy? Yeah, we all watch, right? So if you see, a lot of stand-up comedians, they have their prepared material. But have you seen, they pick up a lot of, they bring out a lot of humor from the stuff which people are doing there, from the audience. You see, the way they are sitting or the way they are looking or they say something, they pick up from that. Now, that's situational humor, where, you know, you pick up things from around you and see how you can make it humorous. Now, why it works well is, along with you, the other people are also experiencing the same thing. Because that particular person, that particular situation is existing there for everybody to see. So when you take up that situation and make some humor out of it, they all connect to it very easily because they're all part of it. Yes. You know, whereas when you make some humor and bring it here and throw it out, they're not part of what you prepared. So there is a disconnect. Whereas situational humor, the audience is also part of what's happening. So they connect very easily and that creates laughter immediately.
Hi sir, my name is Abhijit. So my question is, like, what, you're a good table topic speaker. So what are your steps to telling a good table topic?
When it comes to table topics, it is also a speech, right? A very short speech, but it should have a structure, as we learn, you know, it should have an opening, a body and a conclusion. And there are some very simple tips that you can use on how to open, how to have the body of the speech and how to close. Now, that is an educational session, which obviously we can't answer in this interview, but definitely we can do an educational session on that. But more than everything else, in a table topic session, in a club meeting, what is most important is, don't think that you have to give a good table topic speech. Because the moment you start thinking that you have to give a good table topic speech, you will stress yourself unnecessarily. So just when you get a chance to come and speak, when you are called upon, just come here and say whatever comes to your mind. When you keep doing that, you will automatically find that you gain confidence. And when you gain confidence is when you are able to put all these thoughts together in a very structured way.
Yes.
So initially, don't think anything. Just come here and say whatever comes to your mind, no matter what the topic. If it is related to topic, well and good. If it is not, also just speak. And the more you come here and speak, the more you gain confidence. And that is, confidence is what helps you then to get your thoughts together in a structured way.
Try our best. Thank you so much for accepting our invitation and spending your valuable time with us. I'm sure all of our Gavaliers today will definitely cherish your messages and you will definitely be an inspiration to all of us. So thank you so much.
Thank you very much. And I too thank all of you for inviting me, first of all. But like I said earlier, what I'm really happy is in this Gavel Club, Tejas Gavel Club, you are doing more than what is required. You know, you're getting out of that comfort zone and going that extra mile. And believe me, that is where the real benefit is.
Thank you.
So all these efforts that you're doing, all these, the enthusiasm in trying out new things, doing new things is what is going to help you a lot. So congratulations to all of you and to the counselors and coordinators of Tejas Gavel Club. And wish you all the best. Merry Christmas and wish you all a very happy new year.
Please subscribe to Positive Media Channel for future updates. Also, click the bell icon for timely updates. Do share our YouTube link among your friends and family.